many a tragic story in our annals oft retold. How sailors brave their strength they gave up to the savage cold. How many's a life was saved and warmed by a friendly outstretched hand. And in dire events how providence brought out the good in man. That's how it was that February 1942, when death in a raging blizzard from out the southern blew, and the victims when that awful dawn broke on Placentia Bay, were the Truxton and the Pollux bound for Argentia Base, bound for to help the Allied cause and Hitler's grip to free. The mighty hand of Uncle Sam was welcomed heartily. But now, of course, by 30 miles, the two ships blindly drove upon the stark cold, merciless Long Point and Chambers Cove. As the great ships beat on the raging reefs, with sailors numbed and shocked, and many who swam to grasp for life were dashed against the rocks, while the black eye bleeding from the tanks blotted the raging tide, and men in tearful agony cried out to God to die. When the people of Lon and St. Lawrence got the message of despair, their thoughts were of those helpless men and how their lives to spare. Those Newfoundland-bred fisher folk built off the sturdy stuff made for that treacherous icy ledge to call disaster's bluff. How the mighty has fallen, like the ancient poet said, this winter gale with its frost like hell claimed 204 men dead. By the meek that he chose to deliver those not yet meant to die, 180-odd by the grace of God were hauled from that grave alive. There's many a tragic story in our annals of yesterday, and the loss of the Truxton and Pollux will forever in memory stay. For a monument to the living and dead in St. Lawrence proudly stands, to represent how providence brings out the good in man. It represents how providence brings out the good in man.